Hibernate provides two features that enable you to define additional filter criteria that Hibernate applies to every query that selects a specific entity class. This video will show you how to use the filter def and filter annotations, which is the more flexible approach. You can activate and deactivate filter definitions for your current session and use dynamic parameters in your filter conditions that enables you to adjust the filter conditions at runtime. In a previous video on implementing soft deletes, I showed you the where annotation. It's similar to Hibernate's filter feature, but less flexible. The condition defined in the where annotation is always active, and you can't use any parameters to customize it. If you're looking for a simpler, static approach to define filter conditions that will be added to your query, make sure to watch that video. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. I'm here to show you how to build incredibly efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring. Subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. This shows me that I should create more videos like this one, and it helps me reach more people with it. The most powerful and complex filters use a parameterized filter definition with a default condition. These and the ones without a default condition are the most relevant in real-world applications. So let's take a look at them first. Before you can use a filter, you need to define it. You do that using Hibernate's filter def annotation, which you can apply on the class or package level. The name attribute is its only mandatory attribute. Each filter definition requires a name that's unique within your persistence context. You will use this name when you apply a filter definition to an entity class or attribute. In addition to the name, you can also define an array of parameters and a default condition. I set both in this example to define a filter that limits the result set to professional players. The parameters attribute accepts an array of param def annotations. Each of them defines the name and type of a parameter that you can use in the default condition of the filter def or the condition of the filter annotation. In this example, I reference the professional parameter in the default condition. The default condition attribute accepts the SQL snippet that Hibernate will add to the generated SQL statement. After we defined the filter, it's time to apply it to an entity. You can do that by annotating an entity class, attribute, or method with the filter annotation. I annotated the chess player entity class with a filter annotation to apply the filter definition to this entity class. This only connects the filter definition with the entity class, but it doesn't activate it. This requires another step, which I will show you in the next section. As you can see here, the name attribute of the filter annotation references the filter definition that we defined a few seconds ago. That filter def annotation provides a default condition which Hibernate will apply when we activate this filter. Hibernate's filters are deactivated by default. If you want to use a filter, you need to activate it on your Hibernate session. You can do that by calling the enableFilter method on your session with the name of the filter def that you want to activate. The method returns a filter object, which you can then use to set the filter parameters. This activates the reference filter definition for all entities that referenced it, and it stays active until the end of the current session or until you call the disableFilter method with the name of the filter definition. Let's activate the previously defined filter proFilter and set the professional parameter to true. When you execute this code and activate the logging of SQL statements, you can see in the log file that Hibernate added the SQL snippet provided by the filter def annotation to the SQL select statement. In some situations, you might want to define a reusable filter that you can apply on different columns. You can specify a condition that matches different database tables and columns. But as mentioned earlier, the default condition attribute of the filter def annotation is optional. As I will show you in the next section, you can define a custom condition on the filter annotation. Let's check it out. In this code snippet, I create a filter definition without a default condition, but with two parameters of type localDate. If you don't set the default condition, you need to provide a condition when you apply the filter to an entity. You can do that by providing an SQL snippet to the condition attribute of the filter annotation. In this example, I use that when applying the date filter definition. For my chess player entity, I want to use that filter on the birthday column. And I apply the same filter to the date column of the chess game entity. This time, I annotated the date attribute instead of the entity class with the filter annotation. But that doesn't make any difference. In your business code, you need to activate the filter in the same way as in the previous example. You need to call the enableFilter method on your session and set all parameter values on the filter object. Using the same filter definition on multiple entity attributes might look like a very comfortable way to reuse a filter. But please keep in mind that you activate the filter definition for the entire session and not only the next query. After activating the date filter in the previous code snippet, Hibernate will apply it on all queries executed as part of the current session that fetch chess game or chess player entities. Depending on the semantics of your filter, this can cause unexpected results. Another commonly used filter definition uses a static default condition without any parameters. These usually check if a Boolean flag is true or false, or if a date is within the current month or year. Here you can see a static version of the Pro filter that I showed you in the first example. This time it checks if the Pro column contains the value true, instead of comparing it with a provided parameter value. It's of course less flexible than the previous filter definition, but especially for Boolean flags, this is often good enough. You can apply this filter definition in the same way as any other definition that provides a default condition. You only need to annotate your entity class or attribute with a filter annotation and reference the definition in the name attribute. This filter definition doesn't use any parameters. Due to that, you only need to enable it in your business code by calling the enableFilter method. In all the previous examples, we applied the filter definition to a mapped column of the table mapped by the entity class. If you want to do the same for a column that's part of an association table of a many-to-many or a unidirectional one-to-many association, you need to annotate the attribute or method that defines the association mapping with a filter join table annotation. This is the only difference to the filters and filter definitions that I showed you before. In this example, I added the filter def annotation to the same entity class, specified a parameter, and defined the condition on the filter join table annotation. You can then use the same enable filter and set parameter methods to activate the filter in your business code as we used in the previous code samples. Before you start using Hibernate's filters in your application, you should be aware of two limitations that cause issues in many applications. Hibernate's second level cache is independent of your current session and its specific filter settings. To ensure that an activated filter doesn't cause inconsistent results, the second level cache always stores the unfiltered result, and you can't use the filter and cache annotation together. Hibernate only applies the filter to entity queries, but not if you are fetching an entity directly, for example by calling the find method on the entity manager. Due to that, you shouldn't use a filter to implement any security feature, and you should check your application carefully for any direct fetch operations. Hibernate's filter def and filter annotations enable you to specify additional filter criteria which Hibernate will apply to all queries that select a specific entity class. At runtime, you need to activate the filter, and you can customize them by providing different parameter values. That enables you to adjust the filter to the specific needs of each use case and session. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to lots of member-only content, like cheat sheets and ebooks about defining efficient mappings and the best ways to query your data. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!